If you've spent any amount of time learning about character animation in After Effects, then you've undoubtedly heard of a little tool called Duik. Duik is by far the most popular tool associated with character animation in After Effects, and if you search character animation for After Effects on YouTube, you'll be met with an ocean of tutorials featuring Duik. With Duik being so popular, you'd be forgiven for not even knowing that there are actually a bunch of really good alternatives to Duik. However, if you're a subscriber to my channel, you're well aware of the alternatives because I've covered them in previous videos. You're also probably aware that my favorite character rigging tool is a little tool called Limber. So in this video, I wanted to give you 5 reasons why I choose Limber over Duik for character animation. But before we jump into the first reason, let's start with a disclaimer. First, the link in the description is an affiliate link, which means I will get a small commission on any sales made through my link. If you ever decide to purchase Limber in the future, I'd appreciate it if you coming back to this video using my link to make that purchase, because it is a small way you can support this channel and it doesn't cost you any extra. With all that being said, the amount of money I will get from any affiliate purchases of Limber is not even close to compensating me for the amount of time I put into this video. This video is purely made out of a desire to expose more people to Limber because I genuinely think it is a great product. With that disclaimer out of the way, let's start with my first reason why I choose Limber over Duik, and that is Limber is easier to use. To create a working limb in Limber is as easy as clicking a button. The same can definitely not be said about Duik. Duik has entire courses dedicating to teaching you how to rig up characters, to say nothing of actually animating those characters. Do you want to be a character rigger or do you want to be a character animator? Even when it comes to characters with lots of details, Limber's rig and pose tool is well thought out and doesn't require hours of research to figure out because it's designed to be pretty straightforward. The biggest hurdle to learning Duik is the amount of prerequisite knowledge you need in order to effectively rig even just basic characters. And unfortunately, a lot of the tutorials I've seen out in the wild always seem to start with the rigging process, and they don't really cover how to design your character to be rigged effectively, which, if you want your rig to work properly, is crucial. If you're a beginner, you're not aware of these prerequisite knowledge that you need before you start rigging, so you end up frustrated when your character rig falls apart as soon as you start trying to move it around. Trust me, I've been there. Limber will save you hours of frustration. Limber requires a lot less prerequisite knowledge because it keeps the rigging process simple, which leads me to my second reason. The simplicity of Limber means it is much less bloated than Duik. The rigging process for Duik is modeled after methods found in 3D applications by placing your bones over your artwork, parenting your artwork to those bones, and then rigging up those bones. Now, this method results in an astronomical amount of layers in your timeline. Let's compare these two rigs. One I made with Limber and one was made with Duik. Limber has 28 layers and Duik doubles that at 65 layers. Now, it wouldn't be fair for me to not acknowledge that there are definitely ways you can make Duik less bloated, like foregoing the bone system entirely and just rigging up your layers directly, which, by the way, is what I usually do if I'm using Duik. But if I do this, the same rig is now only 19 layers, and that's even less than Limber. However, there are a few catches. First, you're giving up some of the functionality that makes Duik unique, like its foot rigging system. And second, if you mess up with the rig like I did here with not quite aligning the knee correctly, it becomes incredibly hard to correct without starting over. And before you suggest I use the edit button, that edit button only works when you're using the bones and before you've auto-rigged it. Once everything is auto-rigged, that edit button does not function anymore. I find a lot of the time spent with Duik is often because there is an issue with my rig and I have to go back to square one. Very frustrating. Speaking of time, that brings me to my third reason I choose Limber over Duik. Limber is built to save you time. I chose my words very intentionally there. Limber is purposely built to save you time. Let me explain using 3 examples. First, Limber is built to be proactive about keeping you organized. Anytime you create a new limb, it prompts you to give that limb a name. So no limbs named Shape Layer 1 by default. If you try to give 2 limbs the same name, Limber will say, nope, you already have a layer called Left Arm. Try again, bucko. This proactiveness is consistent even when you're creating your limbs using the duplicate button. Which brings me to my second example, the duplicate button. 90% of the time, your character's limbs will be symmetrical, so why would you spend the time doing the same work twice? To duplicate a limb, just select one of the three layers associated with that limb, and Limber will duplicate everything, including the controller layers. Duik has a duplicate feature as well, but it only duplicates the bone layers, and you have to duplicate your art layers yourself and make sure they are correctly parented to the new bone layers, which is doable, but way less intuitive than just selecting your limb and hitting the duplicate button and having a brand new working limb. Next, onto my third example. This example comes from a question that I get in my comment section a lot. I think this question comes up a lot because with Duik, like I've pointed out several times, when you wanna make a change, it's so tricky you end up starting over anytime you need to make an adjustment to your limb. Limber has a copy and paste tool that makes changes easy to do even if your character is already animated. You can simply create a new limb, copy it, and paste it to your existing animation. And this just pastes the limb style and leaves the keyframes on your limb untouched. All this saved time leads me to my fourth reason I love Limber more than Duik, and that's because Limber gets you to the animation phase quicker. Now, if your goal is to be a good animator, you need to practice animation. That's a no-brainer, right? Every minute you spend rigging your character is a minute you could spend on finessing and perfecting your animation skills. Rigging cannot entirely be avoided, but you can pick tools that allow you to maximize your animation time as much as possible, and for me, Limber does this. This is actually a perfect time to segue to this video's sponsor, Skillshare. Now, I have been a longtime member of Skillshare, so when they contacted me to sponsor a video, I was like, heck yeah, let's do this. If you don't know what Skillshare is an online learning platform that offers classes on thousands of different topics ranging from productivity to creativity. They even have some really good classes on After Effects. Now, the most recent class that I've actually been taking and enjoying is Thomas Frank's Productivity for Creatives. This class is all about building a system that works to help you reliably and consistently put out your best work. This class has been a huge game changer for me because being productive and consistently creative is by far the most challenging aspect of being a freelance motion designer and a content creator. If you are either of those things, you can definitely relate to what I'm saying. One aspect of Thomas Frank's class that is particularly relevant to the topic of this video is designing a workspace that removes as much friction as possible from the tasks you want to accomplish. And one aspect of doing that is looking at the tools that you use and identifying where there is friction so that you can reduce that friction by either replacing or upgrading that tool, which perfectly encapsulates why I love Limber, because it removes a lot of the friction of the rigging process by simplifying it so that I can dedicate more of my precious time doing the things I enjoy doing, like animating the characters, and spending less time doing the things that I don't enjoy doing, like wrestling with Duik to set up the character rig. I cannot recommend Skillshare enough, and the first 1,000 people to use the link in the description can get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. And trust me, most of the classes on Skillshare are not super long because they're really well put together, so don't have to be. So you really can take advantage of that free month to discover a lot of new skills. So don't waste any time and go join Skillshare today. Now, on to my fifth and final reason why I choose Limber over Duik. Limber opens up the possibilities for more dynamic and interesting character animation. Like this animation I made to celebrate 7,000 followers on Instagram. This kind of perspective shift is possible because Limber gives you control over the length and width of your limbs as keyframeable properties. Foreshortening is a thing that has been very absent from character animations in After Effects until Limber came along. Also, things like the direction of your limb bend and the switch from IK to FK are all on sliders instead of switches like they are with Duik. This makes switching much more natural and smooth, enabling things like crossbody movement. The added dimension that effects like foreshortening can add to an animation really excites me and makes it hard for me to ever consider picking Duik or really any other rigging tool over Limber. So there you have it. I choose Limber over Duik because it is easier to use, less bloated, and built to save you time, which means you can get to the animation phase quicker to create more dynamic and interesting animations. But I'm interested to know what you think. Do you use Limber or do you use Duik? I'm curious to know the reason why you might stick to Duik. Did I get anything wrong? If so, let's hear it in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, join me in my battle against the almighty YouTube algorithm and like the video so the algorithm is forced to suggest this video to a wider audience. Also, if you're a motion designer who is learning character animation, make sure you're subscribed because we'll have more videos coming soon, as well as go check out some of my other videos on the subject. Like I said, I have videos on both of these tools for you to check out. So go check those out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.